byange.
So how do you be established?
Osimbi botya.
Now obe ko byokoze.
So that you have done something.
At least you
leave a heritage when you leave.
Gundi yazimba company hiyo.
So and so build this company. Build this school. Build this
school.
Build this
school.
Build hotels. They are still working to this day.
How do you get established? You believe God. How do you believe God? Jehoshaphat was a praise worshipper. He was the leader of Israel. And he came to Judah. Judah means praise. Jehoshaphat is you. You are coming to your praise. He said, listen to me. We believe God. How do you believe somebody? How do I believe my wife? She's a good preacher. I believe her when I praise her. I tell other people, I said, my wife is the best preacher. Because I know if she takes the service, the anointing will fall. Sometimes we don't praise God in the situation where you are. You praise God for what he has already done. And then your praise tell the current situation, you better leave as well, because God has never done it, dealt with you before. Child of God, Joseph was put in the dry pit. It was Judah who picked him up. And Judah means praise. How do you believe God? By praising him for what he has done. I said, by praising God. Sit down, everybody. By praising God for what he has done. Now get up on your feet and clap your hands and praise God. Sit down. You see, religion destroyed you. Religion destroyed you. He never taught you how to praise God. They taught you how to beg. When you pray, you are beggar. Instead of being a believer, you come to the Lord. The only weapon you have is your praise. Remember that you are the last creature God created before he rested. He made an elephant before you. He made a giraffe before you. You are a result of his good work. Why did he create you? He says so that you may be in dominion. But much more, you may lead a praise. You may be the one who tells everybody that God can do it. You can tell the cows that God can do it. That's why Noah was found favor before the Lord and grace, because he told all the other animals, others may die but you can live. People of God, God, hear me very well. It is your praise of your God that will get you out of the dry pit of poverty. Right now, some of you are in the dry pit. There's no money. You can't pay your rent. You can't get a job. You can't get married. People have thrown you there. Tradition has thrown you there. Your age has thrown you there. The only thing to get you out is to praise the Lord. But the problem is, sit down. Religion never told you how to praise God.
They
taught you how to beg. Oh God,
oh Katonda,
big-eyed, Katonda
oh God in heaven, we are so badly off. We came from Bugerere, then we came over here. They treated us bad. We are suffering.
God knows that. Katonda, he is
almighty.
He knows you came from Kotido.
Yes, he said, don't pray repeatedly. When you come before me, don't pray repeatedly. Tell God,
God,
I
want to
eat beef today. In Jesus' name. Nobody told us how to pray. They told us how to pray.
So never jamu kanisa.
When you come to church, you sit on your seat.
No one can be get it.
And lift your legs.
No one can praise the Lord.
Say, praise the Lord.
Such attitude.
attitude cannot break her out. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they were in a fire. They start praising God. Paul and Silas, they were in prison. They praise the Lord. Somebody this morning, you must get up and praise God like a crazy person.
You see,
because nobody told you how to praise God. You don't know what it means to praise God. You think it's clapping hands and standing up and shout for 3 minutes or 2 seconds and then you keep quiet. Nobody told you how to praise. Nobody told you how to praise. You don't even understand what you're doing. God says this.
Remember the Lord thy God. Because it's he who gives you power to create wealth. Remember the Lord thy God.
What are you remembering him about? Why are you remembering him?
What he did for you in the past. And you can only praise him when you testify. When you go around telling everybody, even telling the current situation, you may have come with all kinds of power,
but I have a God.
He got
me out.
He gave
me out again. I'm not
going to
beg. I have a living God. The first Christian, they were so powerful. Make them overcome sin.
Because
they knew how to praise.
Yesu, Yesu, oli mwana gwande. Obamu taxi, obamu basi, obamu nyumba.
Wherever they were.
O musai, gunaziza, nebaza, o mulokozi.
You can't even sing it. Your voice is bad.
You sing in a very loud way. You deliver.
You sing like that. Religion messed you up.
On the overnight, there was a lady from Kasese. She had HIV. We prayed for her here. She
came back yesterday with 3 different results. When she left the service,
she
got her card. Went and be checked.
They said
you're negative. The second time, she went
and
found her
negative.
After 31 years,
God.
You saw how she was worshiping God. Religion messed you up.
Then
you added the Pentecostal. You lift your hand and got into a spirit. Not the real Holy Spirit. Because the real Holy Spirit will make you drunk. Will bring you joy. Will bring you laughter. Will bring you cry. Will bring you jumping. You feel your own spirit. And you do this way.
Yes, Jesus.
We were, yes.
I know.
Mani.
You know me.
Oh, mani.
Mukama nagamba, who are you?
God said, who are you?
I'm looking for those who worship me in the spirit and truth.
This is the truth.
Truth is the truth. This is the truth you are looking for. Truth is the.
You don't have money. You are still renting. You are so. You have never been married. You have never married. You have debt.
That is the truth.
Worship God in that truth. We'll be right back. Mukama musinze mazima.
Praise him in that truth.
Mukama mugambe sirina sente. Na ye kutendereza.
But I praise.
Sina fumbirwa.
I'm not yet married.
Na ye kutendereza.
But I praise.
Chari mulwadde.
I'm still sick.
Na ye kutendereza.
But I praise.
Sirina manyi.
I ain't got power.
Na ye kutendereza.
But I praise.
Feria kushinga.
No one is like
unto you. Feria kushinga.
There is no one like you.
Nobody is like you.
Feria kushinga.
Nobody is like you.
Feria kushinga.
You are the lily of the valley.
Where should we jump?
You are the rose of Sharon.
Where is your Sharon?
You are the mighty God.
Where is your God?
You are the soon coming King. You are my El Shaddai.
El Shaddai.
You are my Jehovah Jireh. I praise you. I praise you. Jehoshaphat said,
Jehoshaphat Naga,
hear me, Israel.
Mumpulire Israel.
He was a king.
Yali kabaka.
He said, the joke is over.
Nti okusaga kukomye.
Religion is over.
Edini ekomye.
They were in the wilderness.
Bali mudungu.
No water, no money, no food.
Terimazi, teri center, teri
the enemy is surrounding them.
Omulaba betolode.
And he said,
Nabagamba,
believe God.
Mukirize Katonda.
Believe God.
Mukirize Katonda.
You will be established.
Muna asimbiwa.
How do you believe God?
Mukirizo cha Katonda.
You believe God by praising him.
Ngomutendereza. You come to a sick person and say in the name of Jesus, God is able. Nothing is impossible. He's a miracle worker.
I'm
just coming out of revival. A miracle is going to happen to you.
Praising God will get you out of the pit.
Chija kuja mchinya mondeneza Katonda.
Aba mukume muri mchinya chiwamvu cho wavu.
You are in a deep poverty pit.
The enemy is trying to kill your vision, trying to kill your dream. But praise will get you out quick, will pull you out. I say praise will pull you out of the pit. So you believe God by praising him. Now how do you believe a prophet? How do you believe a prophet? Who is the prophet, by the way? There are so many prophets in
Kampala.
But I'm not talking about those. I'm talking about the true prophet of God. What is the minister of prophecy? To admonish. In other words, it repeats what God says about you. Nabiye naba jagaraga togenda kufencha.
Prophet says you're going to die tomorrow.
Chichuse mangunyo.
Switch that
prophecy. Now government watu bayogera mukama.
Say that saith the Lord.
Chinza agenda okufa.
It's not me who is going to die.
Wabula yogedde kufa yanafa.
The one who has spoken death is the one going to die.
Kubanga Yesu yaje tumene obulamu tumene bubunji.
Jesus came and we have life and have more abundant.
You hear what I'm saying?
Uli ashengamba.
Whoever comes and says ogenda kuba mwavu, oja kusirana, oja koloja,
betandika
kutendereza.
Start praising.
What by Yogera Mukama? I am established by the Almighty God. I am like a tree planted by the riverside. I shall not be moved. So, how do you believe a prophet? The prophet repeats what God says. And how God speaks. Through his word. Believe a prophet, you shall do what? I can't hear you. Believe a prophet, you shall do what? How many of you want prosperity? Sit down. How many of you want prosperity? So how do I get prosperity? I believe a prophet. So how do I believe a prophet? Zechariah chapter 8 verse 12.
Zakaria 8:12.
He says,
Agamba,
the seed
ensigo
shall prosper.
Ejakula kulana.
The seed, ever said
the seed
shall do what?
Shall prosper.
The seed shall do what?
Ensige nakula chenakula kulana.
The seed shall do what?
I can't hear you with a loud voice. Read the verses. 1, 2, 3, go. For the seed shall be prosperous. So where do I get a seed to believe in the prophet? How do I believe the prophet? The prophet is about prosperity. Some prophets about healing. You know, prosperity is nothing missing, everything available. That's the meaning of prosperity. Nothing missing, everything available. Healing available. Miracles available. Laughter available. Children available. Housing available. Clothes available. That's what the meaning of prosperity is. So how do I get into prosperity? How do I get into prosperity? I believe a prophet. How do I get a prophet? Because prosperity demands a seed. What is the seed? What is the seed? In the Gospel of Luke, our Lord Jesus Christ teaches us about the seed.
Yes,
and
said
so the seed is the word of God. The seed
ensigo
is the word of God.
Chigambo cha Katonda.
You see? So how do I believe the prophet? I believe the word God has given him for me.
Nzikirize chigambo kama cha mwadenga change.
There are two types of words of God. There is the
logos,
which is the written word. Then there is the rhema. Now rhema hinges on what we call kairos in the Greek. The time God told us. We were doing crusade number 49. We had already set Chiriandongo to be crusade number 50. We felt God wanted us to go there. Then as I was in Chiriandongo, God said, no, don't even do a prayer breakfast. Drive back. Preach to the people. And I said, God, what? And
he
said, 77 days. 77 dogs. Let the people drink water like a dog. Have you ever seen a dog drink water?
He
doesn't use his hand to remove the dirt. He just happy. He said, if the people will drink water like that, if they will drink the Holy Ghost like that, I will do wonders. I will shake the whole nation. I will throw everybody. We are seeing this one happening. Miracles said that we are seeing this happening. So that is the kairos. That is the rhema word on kairos. In time, thank God for the logos. But what you need now to get out of your poverty, your sickness, your disease, your fear is the rhema word. And that's what he's talking about. Go back. For the seed is the word. Let's read it together. 1, 2, 3, go. Luke 8:18. The scripture is on the screen. 1, 2, 3, go. What is the seed? What is the seed? It is the seed that prospers. So it's the word of God that prospers, which is given to you in time. 77 days. 77 days. 77 days. Child of God, if you don't understand what I'm talking about, because some of you don't even come in the 77 days. But let me talk to those who have always come. We've had testimony that I was watching something else. Then every station switched off except Channel 44. We've had testimony here that someone did it, even the TV was off. But the voice of Channel 44 was coming through. Everybody who stands there says, I thank God for Channel 44. I didn't know where Channel 44 was. Who told them about Channel 44? That there is a revival. The Holy Ghost. Because he gave the word. And we believe the word. By the way, we didn't start on TV. On the 18th of October, I just flew in from the country on Saturday. We didn't even put on TV. It was on Friday that we put it on TV. But as soon as we put on TV, we didn't advertise. There's no billboard.
But the crowds are breaking records. People are coming. You watch what's going to be here tonight. If you don't come early, you don't have a seat. Look at the crutches. This. These are not healed in another crusade. These are healed here. People of God, I want you to hear me. Every day we stand here for 9 hours. Where do we get the energy? 9 hours. We have banned witchcraft. I'm telling you, we have banned witchcraft. The witchcraft we have banned this, since we began 6 weeks ago. We are starting the seventh week tomorrow, tonight. It is equivalent to the witchcraft I've burnt in 30 years. And we are not yet finished. We still have 11 weeks to go. Child of God, I want you to hear me. If you are going to prosper in your life, you need a rhema word. That's how you believe in the prophets. Because prophets don't manufacture their word. They don't manufacture their word. They repeat what God has said about you. God has said you are the head and not the tail. The Lord has said you'll borrow, you'll lend nations and you'll never borrow. The Lord said you live in good old age. With long life, he will satisfy you. That's what you repeat. That's what you say. I don't care who's bewitching you. I don't care who's plotting to kill you. You believe the word of the Lord, you shall prosper. Tell the person next to you. Don't tell me the words of the witches. Tell me what the Lord is saying. I can't hear you. You are very weak. You can't talk like that and then expect to get a miracle. Some of you need to become aggressive in your spirit. The way you speak, you don't get a miracle. I don't get a miracle. The seed is the word of God. The seed is the word of God. So what is the word of God? What is the rhema word for miracles? What is our rhema word? He said 77 days. We started it. We are running. The whole country. The whole television industry. People don't even understand. The highest pro television right now. Highest rated television right now. Program on TV right now in the whole country is on channel 44 called 77 dogs. Thank you for your love's enthusiasm. Okay, sit down. That was the word he gave us. And the word has changed our lives. It has changed our way of looking at things. We are here. Those who didn't come, you missed. There was a sister who was praying for the husband. Married a witch.
Nazale yomwana
produced
Sudan.
Went to Sudan. Dropped the kid, left the kid there. The lady came to touch the husband. God touched the husband. The husband also came. While they were here on the pulpit speaking, the brother to the wife also had issues. He also came. And so the sister
was.
So he came to the pulpit. He came with a friend of his who was going to marry the grandma. Marry a woman big enough to be the grandmother. It is very difficult for such people to meet in a place like this one.
The brother of the wife was talking about his brother-in-law, not the one that was in the pulpit. The husband of
so-and-so
taught me the tractor.
He said,
he's right here. So what? He almost dropped the mic. The power of God drew each one of them from wherever they were.
God has
brought the money they need to come to you.
Tendereza mukama utulide chimukazi gwe ku bizibu byolina.
Praise the Lord.
Tula wansi.
Please be seated.
So what is the Rhema word? The Rhema word is very simple.
Changunyo.
The Lord has given us, he gave it to us on Friday. Psalms 68. Fenga Church. 77 days is for the whole world. Is for the whole place.
Chansi yonna.
Mubalaba wibachi. Uyu, abaita obedda tambule ne kumacha.
She's been walking since morning. She's not okay. Upstairs. She's here. You see her in 2 days when she's ushering in church.
You see, right now the ushers are not enough, so we are recruiting. The ministers are not enough, they are recruiting. But ushers,
the ushers, they were ushers
for 30 years.
They are old and weak in body.
They are supposed to be supervisors.
Katibai noko wa supervisor baba no bakanyama abato abaina kunyama.
The way we used to know church is no longer the way we know.
Engage to admani kanisa siweri kakati.
We don't even know where the energy is coming from, but the Holy Spirit. So he gave us the word. How? Remember, the world is coming to receive from us. Okay? So what is it in for us? Psalm 68. Look in Psalm 68. Verse 1. Let's read it together. 1, 2, 3, go. Let God arise and let his enemies be scattered. Let those who hate him flee before him. Tell your neighbor, say, let God arise.
Let God arise.
So how do you let God arise?
Mukama omuleka otyo kuhimuka.
For a long time, our God has been down. The best TVs, most watched TV in Uganda, has never been a Christian television. Now, it is. I'm telling you, now it is. And not only for 1 hour, not only for the program, but for 8 hours every day. Muslims are watching. Non-believers are watching. Members of parliament are watching. Listen to this. You may think I'm joking. This is Honorable Betty Kamia. Minister for Kampala. She said, Pastor, I'm requesting for a special service to pray for Kampala. Especially the Chifesi group. The Kosovo thugs. And the young girls who have been stealing valuables. And we see how government can also help. Next Sunday, I am coming. On the 2nd of November. I was watching Channel 44 and I saw how God changed those young people. So I am coming to join in hand. If
revival is here, saints. What we live for is here, saints. You have not yet seen anything. You have seen nothing. The quicker you get involved in the river, the quicker you dip yourself in the river, the quicker you drink the Holy Ghost, the better. So how do you let God arise? You know why people don't get saved? Yet there are many street preachers. Do you know why? You look at the street preachers, their appearance. People pass bypass them. They can't listen to them. Because the way they are dressed, the way they smell, the way they look. But if I come with my Rolls Royce, when's General Rolls Royce? And I've got six beautiful dressed young women in business suits and six young men with bow ties standing over there, each one of them with a sack of sugar, rice, oil to give away to the people, clothes, brand new shoes. And I start preaching. I'm telling you, nobody will go to Wino. They will all surround me while I preach. So tell your neighbor, said, I command you, let God arise. We are hindering us from rising. Our speech, our yawning. Praise the Lord. The first you need to go to Mondo Molini and Moriango. Tell your neighbor, let God arise. Miracle of Atuaga, of Atuaga, Tulino, Kuleka Katonda, Situke. Let God arise. Mumpuli is the Tulino, Kuleka Katonda, Koradia. Let God arise. Ah, Situkaba, Abeba, Koleva, the enemies may scatter. When we finish our baptism, people are fed up. They are praying all night. God has risen in the nation. What is being spoken of in Kampala? That if you don't have a television, that you are bound with religion. What is being talked about in Kampala?
77 dogs on channel 44.
77 days of glory on channel 44. When the Holy Ghost comes and people allow him to rise, he doesn't leave. He does not depart. He's not going to leave Miracle Center. After 77 days, he doesn't want to go anywhere. The money is here. You have the cars. You are wise. You have the houses. People spend the night on the veranda to get places the next day. You come at 5 a.m. or 6 a.m. The veranda is full of people. Timing places the next day. Then you stay home on your little bed. I'm hearing. I don't have a television.
Let God arise.
Where
was Amabanja?
You borrowed.
We will TV, your TV, and take it.
Money and borrow and buy.
Let
TV.
God arise! Invite people. Kenda ku Facebook.
Go on Facebook.
Kenda ku YouTube.
Go on YouTube.
Engineer Shem was telling me.
Engineer Shem was telling me.
He was telling me that people are now watching America.
America.
All over Boston.
Ne Boston.
But now Uganda, but never better on YouTube.
All Ugandans are on YouTube.
You say,
what is YouTube?
Let God arise.
Mukama mulekai muke.
Olokola baba lame babasasa.
Then your enemies will be scattered. You're always contending with people with poverty. Why are you contending with
them? This is the Rema word. Rema word
which God has given
us.
Let God arise.
And
his enemies shall be scattered without us pursuing them. Sicknesses will all depart without us pursuing them. Someone came.
Nanga musomba.
Say, pastor.
Abantu babagambe.
Tell the people.
Walwa babake bintu byabwe.
People are still
investing.
And they throw their bags.
Muri nagamino. Gumuro kola aliwan.
You who is a believer. How do they steal your bag from you?
I was
and then the bag was taken. When you are here, put your bag on. Wear it.
So you keep
your bag even under the anointing. Fall under the power with your bag. Be filled with the Holy Ghost. Be slain. With the bag in your hand and the phone inside the pocket of the jacket inside. People are stealing phones, people are stealing jackets, people are stealing this. Keep your stuff.
My name is him. I didn't sell. I'm telling you, Vamanya, why would you have would?
Even a drunken person knows where they came from. They know the road that brought them. When you're praying, put your bag next on your body. The Holy Ghost is falling. You land on your bag, and if an usher is pulling you, you hold on to the bag.
If other people are going to come and confuse you here,
they will find you here.
Here,
in this church.
Do you want to see Pastor Kayan?
50,000 for red carpet access.
We
have so many security people. Get hold of that guy. There is prayer here. But you also have some prayer at 6 or at midday. You brought yourself. You came here. Why is someone else misleading you? Others will coordinate you from here. Then you end up with somebody you ought not to go with. You'll go with a dude, a fake, an animal. They'll call themselves a pastor. Just because these people are ushering and holding people, you think they are all pastors. Hey, where are we? The other brother, the one who carried me when I fell under the power, I thought he was also like you.
Brother Kacha, Brother Kacha, neri nyali toli mani.
Akwata abagwa. Oyo.
Let God arise.
Leka mukama imuke.
Let God arise.
Holy Ghost is convicting people to return things that are stolen.
On Good Friday,
a
young man came to Pastor David.
Pastor David.
And said, Pastor David, do you remember me? He said, no. He said, I brought you a pad.
Collected the pad.
Pastor David said, oh, thank you. He said, but I brought it in
in place of the, your phone I stole 10 years ago.
Njirese kuwanyisa musimu yeje nakubaka miaka 10 yejise.
Kati abantu bali mukwene nyala 10 yawe.
People are repenting and returning what they stole.
Ngategwa tanaka kubba masimu.
And then you start stealing phones. People are repenting immorality. And you are
revival.
Planning to go and commit adultery and fornication within the revival. You want to die prematurely. People are bringing witchcraft. Muslims. You are sitting on your witchcraft as a believer. You are keeping quiet. The witchcraft is in the house. The stick of witchcraft potion is in your wallet. Muslims are bringing their witchcraft. But you still go to some places to get water in jerrycans.
Let God arise. Let's go ahead. Verse 2. As smoke is driven away, so drive them away. As wax melts before the fire, so let the wicked perish at the presence of God. Go ahead. So now we know how to deal with wickedness. Let's read number 3. 1, 2, 3. But let the righteous be glad. Let them rejoice before God. Yes, let them rejoice exceedingly. You see, if you're going to let God arise, you who is righteous, we have been saved by grace. Come on, rejoice.
Why are you walking with a gloomy face?
Start laughing. Nobody
taught you how to
laugh.
Seka.
If you
want the real joy,
know this, that forced joy is better than genuine depression.
When you start laughing, if you want increase in joy, look on the side. Look at the one who is not laughing. The one who is not laughing will make you laugh. We laughed yesterday. A young man made us laugh. When I came to that woman, my eyes began to hurt. She was so whatever that she caused his eyes to hurt. Seka.
Seka.
Laugh. Hey, hey, hey. Ha, ha, ha.
You see, even the Lord says He loves a cheerful giver. Even your offering without laughter, you've already killed it. If you're bringing an offering, whether it's 10 million,
10 million
without laughter, without cheering, without being happy, you've already cast it. For the Lord loves a cheerful giver. So laugh.
Seka.
Ha.
not only offering. How many of you are not yet married? And you're expecting to get married? Stand up on your feet. Proverbs says, embaga bagikolera nseko.
That's why you're not getting married.
Now laugh.
Seka.
Back to Psalms 68.
Zaburi kaga munana.
Verse 4. Sing to God, sing praises to his name. Extol him who rides on the clouds by his name Yah or Yahweh and rejoice before him. He says, sing to God, sing praises to his name. This is what the Lord is telling us.
If you are here, start praising God. Walk singing to God.
You keep on praising. I praise you, Lord, because in 1 hour miracles are happening. I'm going to hear a phone. Yes, my phone is coming. You see, revival.
It's not what we do at
revival
night. It's what you do every day.
You're going to
go to the toilet.
Hallelujah, Mukama. Hallelujah. That's revival. In the taxi, on the border, at your office. Revival. You welcome the Holy Spirit in the spirit. Place. That is revival.
That is why when you come, you feel exhausted in the church. I left at 3:30 a.m. from the pulpit. But I was first here. I preached the first service. I'm still preaching. Where do I get the joy?
Because
I don't wait for the evening to be filled. Every little moment I get, fill me, O God. Fill me, O God. Fill me, your Holy Spirit. Give me joy. Give me joy. I don't allow anyone to bring me sorrow in this season. No, sir. Take your sorrow. Everything has its time. This is a season of lapping water like dogs. And then you tell us to go back.
Verse 5. A father of the fatherless, a defender of the widow, is God in his holy habitation. Go ahead. God sets the solitary in the families.
Abang, Katonda mazokwe zimbira na mulondo mu families.
God has built his throne in families. Your family. No one is going to be with you. No one will break your families. That's what God is saying.
This is a rhema word.
And you fail to rejoice in God. I don't know if God in heaven. I don't know whether you see me. Poor me.
Rich. He brings out those who abound into prosperity. He brings out those who abound into what?
Prosperity.
He brings out those who abound into prosperity.
If you are bound, you have never built, you are not prospering. God is bringing you out and is taking you to prosperity. That's what you have to be every day. God is taking me out of poverty, taking me out of hunger, taking me into prosperity.
You have heard the word. Verse 7, quickly. Oh God, when you went out before your people, when you marched through the wilderness, go ahead. The earth shook, the heaven. Olaba, ayogera ku mukama byakola.
He speaks about what God did.
Atendereza kanda kube mukama byakoze.
Mwena
bali wana abalokole.
Everyone who is here.
Ujakaya loko sejo.
Unless those who go.
Naye mwena mwena mukama kyaliakole de.
You have a testimony.
Yogera kwe hicho.
Talk about that. God healed your
babies.
God healed your
rich.
God healed your poverty.
You are
not looking good. There was no difference between you and an animal. At 4,
you
start lining up here for testimony. Up to that side. God did for you miracles. You never say anything. Just keep quiet in church. We see you yawning.
Nakumira marusunga amangota. The earth shook and the heavens also dropped rain at the presence of God. Sinai itself was moved at the presence of God, the God of Israel. Olaba revelation Dawudi jalina.
You see revelation
agamane Sinai ya moving.
Even Sinai itself was moved.
I think that's true. Sinai moved.
Sinai was moving
because of the presence of God. When you look at Sinai,
but you also see Sinai.
When Moses was being the shepherd, because he came on mountain
Sinai
and God saw it. Then you find
Sinai
in the way of the children of Israel going to the promised land. Midian is this way. Sinai was this way. But when God came, he moved it.
God has moved some wealth to come from the whole world and come to you.
Somebody must praise the Lord in this house. I say somebody must praise God in this house. 9, 9, 9, 9, 9. We go up to 11 because of time. 9. You, O God, sent a plentiful rain whereby you confirmed your inheritance when it was weary. Go ahead. Your congregation dwelt in it. You, O God, provided from your goodness for the poor. Verse 11. The Lord gave the word. Great was the company of those who proclaimed it.
What God is doing here is unprecedented. It has never been done in Uganda. How many of you have been in revival? 6 weeks. We just renew our strength every time. How many? I don't know how many Muslims have got saved. I don't know how many Muslims have gotten saved. The Saba Christ. I don't know whether he came.
Saba Kristu wuyo
is there.
Yabadde muzibe.
He was blind.
Araba.
He can see now.
bagenda mubatiza
na
service yakagwa
saba
Kristu
saba Kristu. How can we just sit there
what the Lord has done
and fail to publish what God has done?
Katonda yayogera 77 dogs.
God says 77 days of glory.
Katonda,
the Lord has touched people
like
Saba the Hajjis.
Reverend Bali wano juzi.
The Reverend came recently. Have you ever seen it anywhere?
Abantu ne bajula overflow.
And people feel the overflow. Let me testify.
Number one.
Chisoka.
Bulijjo 31st.
Every day on the 31st. That's when we have so many people here.
Fireworks.
We put fireworks. We give them
drives.
We do drives. We do billboards. We speak for a whole month advertising. After the fireworks, midday,
at
midnight, most of them will go. And we stay here and pray until morning. But without any
fireworks,
without fireworks, without muchomo, and people sit outside. If we don't publish this,
we become a weaker company.
Tufuka company enafu.
Katikatonda yawandisiza company ye.
God registered his company of the Holy Spirit.
Na jituza headquarter ku Miracle Center.
And the headquarters is at Miracle Center.
Hakati fe.
Now we.
Tuino kufuruma tugambe.
We must get out and say.
Yabange.
My people.
Tukubise magazine.
Let's do a magazine.
Erimu testimonies abantu.
That has the testimonies of the people.
Abantu bazifune mu office.
People get them in the offices.
Abantu bazifune Kenya.
Get them in Kenya.
Abantu bazifune mu America.
Get them in America.
Ebyogera ku revival eri wano.
Talk about the revival here.
Katonda agamba Ibrahim.
He told Abraham.
Yagamba Ibrahim.
He told Abraham.
That is an overflow.
A overflow.
Naye wabweru wajjudde.
It was packed.
Lounge nejjula.
The lounge was packed.
Friday.
Now this Friday,
we are
putting a tent
out.
Another tent this way.
Screens.
We must put screens inside. God says, let me give you a little dot. Let me bring people. 6 weeks. By the time you get to 10,
last week,
God told us last week that do clear up. I told you. Don't say I didn't tell you.
But
let's prepare that place.
We
will not
remember what church you know.
God, God will every member of this car.
But the problem
is evil.